only purpose of man's sojourn on this earth is to seek God.
Anandam anandakara prasannam jnana swarupam nijabodha rupam yogendra medium bhavarogya vaidyam shrimad gurum nityam maham bhajami. Om. सब आत्मजन को मैं प्रणाम करता हूँ और आज का सत्संग केवल सत्संग नहीं है, ये एक प्रार्थना भी है जहाँ हम एक आध्यात्मिक आभा मंडल में विलीन होने का प्रयास करेंगे. टुडे सत्संग इज नॉट ओनली अ टॉक. Those of you who have been sensitive to my talks, you know that while I talk, I transmit the healing energy. I just wanted to make you aware of this. The way to receive the healing energy while I talk is to let go. Let go of what? Let go of your mind. Let go of your inhibitions. And have a relaxed body language. When you don't lock in front, your hands, you can sit relaxed with your hands up or hands like this, chest slightly out, shoulders drooping, spine straight, this a basic happy sitting position. So the reason for my telling you that as I talk I heal is that I have to use less effort in giving you a direct special healing. So जैसे जैसे मैं बात करते जाऊँगा वैसे वैसे शक्तिपात द्वारा आपके स्पाइन का पेन या बॉडीज पेन्स, इफ़ यू रिलैक्स एंड टोटली बी अब्जॉर्ब्ड, यू नीड नॉट हियर माई टॉक. दैट इज़ नॉट द पर्पज ऑफ माई टॉक. द पर्पज ऑफ माई टॉक इज़ नॉट टू हियर माई टॉक. द पर्पज ऑफ माई टॉक इज़ टू गेट अब्जॉर्ब्ड इन मी. You have to get absorbed in the Sadguru. That is the meaning of satsang. The Guru is like a fountain. He's constantly spraying these photons of light, which by letting go of your inhibition, you can avail of and transform yourself. So when you sit with a master or a Sadguru or a teacher who has these faculties, these virtues, you're actually participating in an alchemy of total transformation. Because the degree to which you are healed depends upon your receptivity of the master. In today's satsang, free from the rough and tumble of daily life, free from the stress and tension of daily life, how can we cope with our daily life and yet keep calm in the eye of the storm? Fanus banke jiski ifazat hawa kare. Fanus banke jiski ifazat hawa kare. Wo shamma kya bujhe jise roshan khuda kare. So this is skill in action. Center in the calm in the eye of the storm. When God Himself becomes the protector, He becomes the lamp glass. You know, when the wind itself becomes the lamp glass and protects the flame of your soul, fanus ban ke jiski ifazat hawa kare, that flame can never die whom God Himself protects. That's what it means. Fanus ban ke jiski ifazat हवा करे वो शम्मा क्या बुझे जिसे रोशन खुदा करे. सो दिस इज वॉट इट इज. दिस इज वॉट यू नो स्किल इन एक्शन इज. एंड इफ यू हैव दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ स्किल इन एक्शन विच यू कैन गेट विद टोटल ट्रस्ट, विच इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू हैव दीज डेज. यू कैनॉट ट्रस्ट अनदर पर्सन बिकॉज द अदर डजंट ट्रस्ट यू. सो When you practice, the only person we can trust today in today's life is the divine indweller, the God within. So Kriya Yoga is a practice of tapping the source to awaken the God within you. That is the science of Kriya Yoga. A rhythmic breathing, tension-free, with Kriya Yoga and concentration, sovereign key. This is important, and this is the message for the new age. We have been told by many people who have prophesied that a great cataclysm will come upon the earth. And many people have prophesied this. It's and also a world war-like situation, a Holocaust will happen. Now, how do we cope with this? How do we protect and shield ourselves against these calamities which are to be upon us soon, from 212 to 222. This is the time. Many a miracle will happen, many a changes will take, but many a stubborn soul will also, a stubborn mind will be removed from their bodies and given better mindsets and a better body. But those who want to continue to serve the work of spiritual evolution and a perfect society, those who want a Shangri-La, actually Shangri-La is a mispronunciation of the word Sambalpur. The Kalki avatar comes from Sambalpur, which is known as Shambhala in America and later called Shangri-La. So ye sab apabhramsh hote gaye hain aur fir Sambalpur se Shambhala or Shambhala se Shangri-La. And the White Brotherhood, people of the White Brotherhood have already started their work to train and teach and transform you to a better world citizen. They are working silently. And soon, you are the people who 400 to 500 years hence will become the sixth civilization, which now we are in the fifth civilization, which was called the Aryan fifth root race, from which is born the sixth sub-race, which we are. We can see it in your eyes, on your cheekbones, on your nose, on your face. Everybody, this is the new this is the new civilization, the new race which is being born. There are a lot of variations, and soon they will all come together, and gradually, as they evolve by the speedy techniques of Kriya Yoga and other means. There are two means to protect yourself and evolve. One is by Surya Yoga and the other is by Agni Yoga. This is laid down in the scriptures and people are teaching you. Agni Yoga is Kriya Yoga, the fire rite of the yogi. And Surya Yoga is the Surya Yoga which I have taught you, and also the Surya Namaskar, ingesting of light, extra light, even if it means by lying in the sun, going to the beach, all these methods. So you have to depend on the ingestion of a greater amount of light to protect you from future cataclysms and a future Holocaust. Cataclysm is, of course, to do with nature, you know, the tilting of the axis, the shifting of tectonic plates, the tsunamis and the earthquakes. They all, you know, add up to make different types of cataclysms, and the Holocaust will be where people, children of the earth, will fight amongst one another, and each will try to eradicate the other. This is to balance the gunas. And then will come the Mashiha, the Savior, the Avatar. Paritranaya sadhunam, vinashanaya cha dushkratam, dharma sansthapnarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. So this is what the Avatar says. He says, I come here to restore the balance where people have gone berserk. When a country or a system deteriorates, like the towns of Sodom and Gomorrah, You know, there were towns which deteriorated and were destroyed. When corruption becomes rampant, so that the good man, the common man, suffers because of an excess. Nobody is saying that a little bit of skill in action and money dealing shouldn't happen. These are natural things. The Lord God is very, very wide in His vision. Only when the balance is upset, He comes to balance the three gunas in human beings and on the earth. And those three gunas, those three qualities which He wants to balance, is the balance between sattva-gun, which is luminosity, rajogun, which is activity, and tamogun, which is inertia. So when inertia rules the roost, people are very lazy, very cunning, surreptitious, they eat stale food, they have dark habits, indulge in malice and hatred and wars. The rajogun activity is different. It's of a more active nature of conquest of countries, imperialism, high activity, good sports. They're good things also. And luminosity is meditation, good thoughts, philanthropic work, sattvic works. But any of the three, the wise ones in India, the sages say that an imbalance of anything is not good. So they balance the three qualities of inertia, activity and luminosity. That's why the avatar comes. Ayotaro, the star descends. It's a downward crossing. He descends first and stretches out to save every single soul. You know, we have songs like Paar karo mera beda bhavani, paar karo mera beda, nadiya gheri nao purani, paar karo mera beda. So this is the avatar, duniya ke taranhar. So avatar is a taranhar. So wo tarta hai. And his message and spirit flows through all teachers all over the world now. There's an intense activity on the causal plane, very intense activity in the astral, the celestial planes, and a mediocre activity which is gaining momentum on the physical plane also, which you will see. It's very interesting how it would combat the inertia and the darker forces. The Sanatan Dharma or the Vedic Varnashram Dharma, dear souls, is a very mature way of life. And each one can live it according to his swadharma. That means his own individual spiritual development. Very, very mature. You see, it's the highest. Where you're not mature, it's like school children. You have to gather them together, muster them, take them to the mosque, gather them together every Sunday, take them to the church. These are younger religions which are still coming. The Sanatan Dharma has crossed this limit. Each one has. In India, you see their own meditation hall or puja or gurdwara, where they do their prayer or the chaitya, the stupa, because they are matured and they have their swadharma. And each one prays according to their swadharma. This is very, very important. Very important to know. And they progress according to their spiritual tendency. Now, as they progress, these things will be upon us soon. We are protecting and shielding and guiding the disciples who come to us so that they may progress. It's all about the evolution of human consciousness. Very important. The evolution of human consciousness, and the lightning path is Kriya Yoga. And this is one of the main purposes. This is the message. Had India no other gift to offer to the world, Kriya Yoga itself would suffice as a kingly offering. This was said by the Gyanavatar Sri Yukteswar. The Kriya Yoga is a simple technique of breathing, a rhythmic breathing in the hollow of the spine, whereby your karma, which is lodged in the genome, the genes and the DNA, gets transformed. And some of the karma gets, so to say, roasted so that it cannot fructify into future negative karma. That is the purpose. Kriya Yoga is an alchemy of total transformation. And now, I would invite questions after a few moments. I don't want you to forget that as I talk, I will be transmitting. It's a healing transmission. It depends upon how receptive you are, how relaxed. Sit in a relaxed position. Let go of the mind. Let go of the mind, let go of the body. And I will take question answers. Can you hear me? Is it echoing too much? So many people ask me about 2012 and, you know, the Mayan calendar had said, given some dates, some other calendar had given some other dates, then there's the Oracle of Delphi, and there's so on and so forth, many other prophecies, you know, the Sibylline prophecy, and then there's the Da Vinci Code. They have all these prophecies saying that a great change shall fall upon the befall the earth, and there shall be good and bad together. It's a mixed bag. We have to skillfully steer our way out of the calamities with which we are beset in the world today. And skill in action is Kriya Yoga. Therefore, dear souls, practice Kriya Yoga. Simple form of rhythmic breathing in the spine. You know, evolution of consciousness takes place through the spine. Many times I see these people who do Tai Chi and this and that, and they're doing this and this. I said, where are you taking the Chi? No answer. What are you doing with the Chi? The Tai is okay. The balance of ayam, the stilling, but they have to channelize it in some place, and that is the Sushumna Nadi. That's missing. So you see, the linchpin of the whole thing is the Sushumna Nadi in all practices. And if you can't get your breath in there, then you're doing a very superfluous and comparatively objective sadhana, not a subjective sadhana. The subjective sadhana is in the hollow of the spine. And that's what Kriya Yoga tells you. Then and then alone does the evolution of the soul begins. You begin to flower into the likeness of your own divinity.